whose name is Code.
Nerd dice.
Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 87 in our series, Creative RubyGem, Nerd Dice. And this episode is kind of be a downtime hodgepodge of a couple different things. So we did have in our projects issue one item about the Ruby Toolbox. So that has been merged. Let me go and see if I can. Ruby Toolbox catalog. So look at our commits. We've got our merge commit. Add nerd dice to math and game libraries. And so if you go to the Ruby toolbox, and look for nerd dice, you can see that it shows up now in math and game libraries. So if you go to math, it shows up, I mean, way, way at the bottom, but it's there. And in game libraries. No, we are not. So look at us working up third from the bottom. We are not the least popular gem on that. I mean, the other ones, our repository is gone, but I think we can call that a win. So move that to done on our backlog. And then we've got another option here. So the unlicensed, which are all of our stuff is under the unlicensed, has a repository of unlicensed free software. You click on the create a ticket, it takes you to here, unlicensed.org, and then it's kind of a sorry, but our princess is in another castle. So you have to go to that. Actually, it's the unencumbered software repo that you'd have to make a. So I'll have to create a JSON file for nerd dice. So we'll get that into our backlog. So we've got it there. Move it into progress, and I will take a look and see. I think you open a pull request to, that's unlicensed.org. Take a quick pause and check this out. So it's not looking all that hopeful that the pull request will be merged in a timely manner, but we'll give it a shot. So I will fork this repo. Under myself here. And then I'll clone it down. So we will go to, I'm just gonna this. So we've got our projects. We will look at an example of it looks like the structure is fairly predictable, so we'll just create a new file here. I will pause and adapt this. So I think I've got everything updated there. So I should have one new file. Write a commit message. All right, so I've got my commit message. Push to the remote. Open a pull request. Create a pull request. And there we go. So that should be, go back to Nerd Dice. Get that in progress. And then we've got, if we go to to stateless code, we do have on our Rails website here the Rails 5 version, we actually have a contributor. So if we go to pull requests here, we've got some dependabot stuff, but we have an actual pull request from an actual contributor to, it's just updating some text on the README, but it is there, so we can look at Martin here. So this was unsolicited. So I, full disclosure, I do know Martin and have known him for, I think, 22 years now. He was one of the groomsmen at my wedding. So we go way back, but he did contribute to this unsolicited. So we'll take a look at this pull request, the so if we look at the actual README here, you can see that the the part that he's fixing here, it is that fix does make things better. I don't know if we can But anyway, you can see it's got the one commit. The commit is verified. It's got the changes there to add in the line break and then get the the bullets fixed. So I think we'll, in the conversation, I'll add a comment. All right, so I've got a comment here. I shall do a merge commit in this case. So go to see the configuration line break and the sub bullets are there. So all right, so let me, I've also got some, while I'm at it, some dependabot pull requests. So let me do is just take a look at all of these, amalgamate them together, and then do an extensive bundle update on this. So that's what I'm going to go for here. So I'll just go to the close this. Open this. Go to the gem file. Oh wow, we're under 5.1 here. Let's see here. How am I gonna do this? Yeah, I guess I'll just find the ones that are listed here. So oh, they're trying to change the gem file dot lock. All right, hold on. So that is a dependency that's in the gem file lock. It's not in the gem file itself. Let me see if there are any. So Puma is in the gem file, I'm pretty sure. Addressable. All WebSocket extensions. So what I will do is I will attempt a bundle update. Okay, so let's try bundle install. Also not working. Okay, mime magic. I'm going to just try going gem by gem through the gem file, seeing if I can get this updated. So paperclip is part of the problem. All right, so paperclip is deprecated. So I think I can get around this by going to 0.3.10. Let's see what our next breaking change is. Okay. This looks promising. Nokogiri is always slow to install. SAS-C is also very slow to install. All right, we ran into an issue with my magic again. Dependencies not in the API or the lock file. All right, try to get ourselves out of dependency purgatory here. So I'm adding in those MIME magic dependencies, hopefully. Now we're all right, it looks like. Okay, so we've at least didn't know how to build a test system. That maybe it might be a Rails 6. Alright, so looking at secrets.yaml, the secret key base and the devise pepper need to exist there, so I will run Rails secret a few times and set some environment variables, and hopefully I'll be able to run the test then. All right, let's try this again. Still not running here. All right, devise initializer. Let's see. I run into the same problem when I try to run the server. That's interesting. Migrations. So it's old, it's ugly, but it's up. Let me see. Still running into problems with that initializer. Maybe I've got the... Let me check the test secret key. Right. Still crashing out here. Let's give it a try. All taking this to production anyway, so. Missing secret key base for test. Oh, you know what? The problem is that I didn't refresh this in the refreshed it in this particular environment. So I've sourced the file where I put the items. Back to no secret key base. So just to get this done, we're gonna hard code some secret key bases. Least. I don't need that long of a pepper for my fake tests here. All right, now we're passing. Oh, it's ugly, but it's passing. All right. Well, check out. Take a look at the gem file dot lock. Make sure that we've got everything we need for these pull requests here. Nokogiri. We need to get it to 1.12.5. Let's see if I can just do a bundle update on Nokogiri. Redo our tests here. Still good. So we'll just Leave that for last. So looking at our gemfile.lock now. Nokogiri is up to 1.12. Puma. It's up to 4.3.10. Addressable. To 2.2.3, which is good, and then WebSocket extensions. That got me up to 0.1.5, which is good. I think we're good. Write our commit message. All right, so we've got our commit message. We shall push. We should now have commits. And we should be able to so we're not running this, so I'm not going to bother with this. Well, oh, and the, looks like the pull requests auto-closed when I resolve them. So I think we'll stop there. We strayed a bit off a nerd dice, but it was good to have an outside contribution, and working with it's always good to go back, and not really always good, but it helps to troubleshoot some old versions of stuff. Sometimes keeps you sharp. So we'll stop there.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Codecast. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. You can follow us on social media at Stateless Code. Until next time, keep coding, and don't aggress against peaceful people or vote for others to do so on your behalf.